trashy tool, I hope it catches on someday. It is indeed our pleasure to see all of you here this day, and I must tell you that I personally have very mixed emotions about being back here in the shadow of the Valley of the Forge. Some remarkable experiences and memories here, if truth be told. You know, when I was appointed Commander-in-Chief of the Continental Army, that was in June of 1775, I told my lady wife in a letter that I would be home for Christmas Eve. I didn't tell her which Christmas Eve. I literally walked across the threshold of our home in Virginia, Mount Vernon, on Christmas Eve, 8.5 years later, without taking a single day's furlough during the entire war. The war itself, in which this nation was raised up, I must say, saw in this valley, this township, and the Valley of the Forge, saw the formation of the army into a unified fighting force. It was in this valley that the crucible of our military strength was formed.
Good afternoon. Your service is in the next hour. We're going to be
now. Well, point. I must also tell you that it was in this valley that the celebration of the holidays would ring true to so many of the soldiers and so many of the camp followers, the distaff, the ladies and the children who followed these camps. And it was a particularly remarkable winter because we suffered greatly, but we paused. We paused to understand the meaning of the holiday as we do each and every year. Part of that meaning, of course, is exchanging gifts with loved ones. And I confess, my lady wife has had her way, which brings us to this remarkable edifice here. Am I right, my dear?
You're absolutely correct, as always.
I hope you are prepared for what is ahead.
I'm always prepared, dear. You know that.
What I mean is, did you bring your purse? Then we are well prepared. I understand that there may be some questions from members of the newspaper press, and it would be our honor to try to field those questions if you have them. If you are afraid to ask the first question, we will take the second question first. Anyone?
General Washington, why the King of Prussia Mall?
Why the King of Prussia Mall? Sir, I must tell you that the King of Prussia, Fred, old Fritz, as we call him, is an individual that I studied with rather a sharp focus. He was a remarkable soldier. He was a great and good leader. He, of course, participated in one of the wars that I fought in. French and Indian War, we called it here, but it was the 7 Years' War. And I will tell you that he was the kind of leader who would lead from the front. He would lead with his troops into battle. He would not say to them, go take that hill. So he was particularly remarkable in my mind and in my heart. I will also tell you that what I mentioned before, sir, it is a time to acquire a small gift here and there for loved ones. And things are rather, well, meager at the Valley of the Forge, the encampment. There is, of course, this highway, around 422, which makes things very difficult to get to the encampment, if truth be told. And we heard of this place. We can see we are in the right place. And we will be buying a little bit in the way of gifts for the holidays. Thus, the King of Prussia Mall, as you call it?
Yes.
I'm used to a mall being a large field or a large courtyard, but this will do.
Washington. Do you enjoy holiday shopping, or is it more of a chore?
Well, I have to tell you, my dear, this today will be a different experience than I have ever had. But I must say I'm much impressed by all of the goods and services that you seem to offer here. And your delightful, colorful decorations are charming. But most of all, it's much warmer in here than it is in those little huts up on yonder hill.
No time for a shave, sir?
No. It's been warm in the winter. Why are you so late shopping this year?
I can answer, because my husband has been so busy. As you can imagine, it is very hectic at the Valley of the Pool. We have about 12,000 soldiers there, and he is very, very busy doing his strategizing for the military operations, that sort of thing. And I consider it my job, really, to keep the boys from roughhousing, you see. And also I'm doing things such as, well, let's see, sewing and darning socks, like that, and putting on buttons, sir. Oh my goodness, button after button after button. General, you would think that in the training for the Continental Army, they would learn, teach those boys to sew on a simple button.
My one thing missed by von Steuben, no doubt. Oh, my dear.
Lady Washington.
I'll just step down.
Has your husband been a good boy this year?
Need you ask? You know, to me, my husband is always a good boy. But if you would ask those politicians down in Philadelphia, you would find out that they are questioning his every move, and they don't believe in his leadership, which I think has been extraordinary. And they are most impatient for him to get everything done in no time at all. And so I'm sure they give you a very different answer, my dear.
They're also very slow to provide money.
General Ossington, do you have any comments on the current events right now?
On the current events right now, such as?
For instance, the log jam in the Capitol.
The log jam in the Capitol. Is the Schuylkill River frozen again? The log jam? I'm not aware of it. It is more than 50 degrees outside. Have you been drinking my whiskey here? Any other questions that you all might have? We're happy to take them on any particular subject whatsoever. Anyone?
Do you have a favorite holiday song?
Oh, I do.
I cannot raise a note.
Oh, well, I like the way you sing, but I do have a favorite tune. It is called Now We Sing of Christmas, and it is from the 15th century French. A real toe-tapper, I'd say.
What about Frosty or Rudolph?
Frosty? Rudolph? Are they infantry men?
My friends, we thank you and wish you joy of the holiday. And we ask you to reach into your purses, be generous in the spirit of this holiday, and enjoy with your family and friends. We remain your humble and your obedient servants.